Evaluator, Toastmasters, guests, and our master of ceremonies in yellow train blue. Trin's objective of this speech was to make the speakers feel good and for the audience to know about the speakers before they come up. That's the essence of what I take from it. And I think, Trin, here's what I thought you did very well in terms of that. First, what I liked from Trin was preparing the introductions for both of the speakers. Here's where, if you don't, there can be some confusion. Trin could have an introduction planned, but if the speaker's like, no, that's not the introduction, that can really take away from the speaker. The other thing that I think Trin did really well to make the speaker feel good is she started the applause, turned, nice firm handshake. Michael was this way, and hands. Those are very important as well. Also, I thought a nice pleasant smile, not only for the audience to feel good, but the speaker also feel good as they're coming up. Here's some suggestions as a master of ceremonies that I would like to see moving forward. First off, when you're introducing a speaker, you're the bridge between the speaker and the audience. So it's important that you answer a couple questions. First off, why this speaker? Why do I want to listen, and what is the subject from the speaker? An example from, and I think you had a lot of this, but I would rework it just so that it's very simple. So what is the subject of Anne's speech? Without giving it all away, I would have said something perhaps. Anne is going to discuss gender roles. And now, why do I want to listen to her? Why is she speaking on this? She's a teacher, she's a wife, she's a mother. That gives her credibility that I'm going to listen to what she has to say. I would also suggest, as the master of ceremonies, sit up here. In a general setting, you'd be at a large table. Because as master of ceremonies, you're the one that people are looking at for the cues of how to react to the speaker. Especially in yellow, you'd really stand up over here by the So if the speaker says something and the audience doesn't really know how to react, you knowing what's going to happen can start, or the laughter or the clapping, the audience will follow. The speaker then will be enticed to continue on. It'll make them feel really comfortable. What I thought was really good is incorporating tonight's theme inside the introductions. Tonight being Quest for Inspiration. So when you have, say it was an anniversary and Trin's the master of ceremonies, how does this tie into the whole evening? Trin did that by getting both of them to have a little bit of introduction. What I would suggest though with that is instead of having them write what inspires them, talk about your personal inspiration from both of them. That would be my suggestion. So why does that inspire you in the Thank you, Trin. Well done. Congratulations.